Hi, my name's Leon Rowe, currency trader and trading coach at trading180.com, and welcome to this video on spatial awareness and risk reward as it relates to supply and demand. And I'll be talking about something called the crowded exit, which is real in the Forex market and in really any market from a technical analysis perspective. So if you are trading supply and demand, or even if you're trading support and resistance, but you're here because you're probably trading, looking to trade supply and demand and know a bit more about supply and demand, is most traders will just look at, you know, a level of demand or supply and then say, okay, well, that's demand, I'm going to take a trade there. Now, there's a bit of a higher level that you need to try to look at when it comes to selecting levels of demand and your entries. So one thing you need to keep in mind is spatial awareness, yeah, as it relates to your risk reward. Now, what do I mean by that? So let's say, for example, let's say we have a market that is trending, yeah, and you have a market that comes up, makes a new high, right, and then starts to pull back to what was known as a demand zone, right? Now, we may see an entry somewhere around here. Yeah. Let me zoom in slightly a little bit. We may see an entry and we may enter right at this entry here. You know, whatever candle that is, that could be, you know, some sort of pin bar. Yeah. Everybody's favorite. And this would have to be, you know, your stop or stop loss. We have to go somewhere around here. Now, we know that if this is a supply zone, and this is demand, this is what the market would consider an expensive area, yeah? So supply equals expensive, and we know that to be true because the market, there was no demand up here. The market didn't want to pay the price. You know, we always have price, and time is going to be obviously the other axis. So this is an expensive area, right? Proven to be an expensive area, and the demand is proven to be a cheap area, obviously depending on what currency pair, you know, you're buying, as far as if you're buying the base or the quote currency. Now, if this is an expensive area and this is a cheap area, and we are entering here, how much upside potential do we have when it comes to our risk reward ratio, right? So risk reward ratio, yeah, how much distance do we have before we may hit what is known as the expensive area? Yeah, now, is this, would this represent a decent trade? Now, a lot of traders don't take this into consideration. They're just looking for areas of demand and then saying, okay, well, this, you know, I've seen an entry, I've seen a pin bar, I'm gonna take it, right? But is that really the smartest play? And when it comes to risk reward ratio, what you want to be is spatially aware. Now, for me, this doesn't represent a decent trade. Yes, you could have probably the perfect setup here, but if you haven't got enough upside potential, yeah, and the reason why you need that upside potential is because the market's already proven that this level here is an expensive area, and it's likely to be expensive in the future when, if prices ever do come up to here, they're going to be what is known as problem areas, problematic areas, yeah. So unless you believe fundamentally that, you know, we are still undervalued down here and prices should go above that, most traders are not fundamentally driven, they are technically driven. But if you believe, obviously, that we are definitely vastly undervalued and that prices should go higher, then, you know, brilliant. But if you're trading this purely off of, you know, technicals, which I really don't recommend, but if you are and one of those technical traders, then you're going to want to at least try to take profit at what would be a problematic area. And if everybody else is looking at this area of supply as a problematic area, guess what's going to happen? Everyone else is going to get out at this level. And if you've bought here, then you have to sell yeah, sell to exit, which means that all, you know, there's gonna be more supply orders from a technical analysis perspective, yeah, and your risk reward ratio doesn't look so good, does it? Because you're gonna have more supply potentially, yeah, than demand, because everyone's gonna be getting out what is known as a crowded exit, yeah, at or just before this supply zone. So if your risk reward represents, let's say, for example, you know, 60 pips, but your upside potential is maybe somewhere like maybe 70 pips from the to the absolute high, then you might say risk reward ratio 1-to-1 is, you know, is decent. For me, I always want to at least attempt to make 1-to-2 or 2-to-1, go for double what I risk, because then it puts lower pressure upon my win rate. And if all I have to do, if I keep going for 2-to-1s, the win rate I need to have just to break even, which basically means not to lose any money, is around about 34-35% if you're going to include, you know, spreads, right? So about 35% just to break even, right? To not lose money, right? Break even. Now the question is, can you be right more than 35% of the time? Of course you can at a 2-to-1 ratio. But the problem is that when you're in a situation like this where you haven't got enough upside potential, you're really kind of capping your risk reward ratio. Now what's the alternative to this? So the alternative to this would be where you have more risk reward. So you have a bit of a pullback, price is making a bit of a new high, right? And when prices start to pull back to a demand zone, this being demand and supply, where your entries now represent, again, this is going to be a bit of a crude pin bar, yeah, where this might represent, again, from your entry to your stop loss, may represent something like, again, 60 pips, but you have an upside potential of potentially, you know, 150 pips. Yeah, from the absolute, you know, demand low to the high may represent more than that. Now that is something that I am interested in. It's because at least if the market doesn't get all the way to the top due to what is known as the crowded exit, yeah, and what that is where traders will tend to take profit and want to take profit before and get out early before other traders. I mean, if you've been in the market, you know, you've felt the urge in order to get out and take profits early. Now when prices are coming to a problematic area, be it a supply zone, yeah, if you're going long, if you're going short, obviously it would be, you know, a demand zone, you want to probably take profit before everybody else, even if you're not necessarily, you know, conscious of it, you're subconscious of that fact, yeah, because you want to take profit before prices end up turning around like what they did in the past, yeah. Same thing with support and resistance. So what you're going to have is, as on the lead up to a supply zone, they're going to be traders who bought down here and they're going to be taking profit just before, you know, the market reaches new highs, because that will be the smart thing to do. Now if this represents, if this crowded exit, you know, represents, and I know the it's not necessarily representative, but let's say for example that was a 2-to-1, right, and this represented 120 pips for example, you're getting out before everybody else. You don't want to be left holding the bag, right? You don't want to be left the one thinking to yourself, well, is, will price, you know, get up here? And if it doesn't get up here and, you know, prices start to reverse again, you're going to start to think to yourself, well, you know, maybe I should have taken profits slightly early before that level. Yeah. So the point is that you want to give yourself enough space right, for price to run to the upside. Yeah, and even if prices don't necessarily even run to the upside, they might run to maybe fair value. If fair value represents, you know, 120 pips, yeah, and your risk is 60 pips, then you know that you have at least, you know, a 3-to-1, potentially even up to a 4-to-1, right, before you get to the highs, which represents a trade that, you know, is a good risk reward. Is 1-to-1 a good risk reward? Potentially, if again you're, you know, you have a high probability strategy and a high win rate, but in my my way of thinking is that I want to be obviously right a lot more than I'm wrong, but I also want those those wins to be, you know, double, triple, quadruple of what I'm making, because then I can obviously make more than just 1-to-1s here, 1.1-to-1s there. The thing is, with when you have a 50% win rate or a 60% win rate, but you're getting 1-to-1s, it can be very challenging to actually just grow your account steadily. You want to really have, you know, good risk reward, 2-to-1s, 3-to-1s, right? And then it also takes the pressure off of you having to have a high win rate as well to make a profit. So let's look at this in the market. So here we are on a pound dollar chart, and this was a demand zone right here, and this was your two supply zones, you know, that would have been marked out from earlier in the week. And again, if you want to follow along with some supply and demand zones, that have a weekly supply and demand technical analysis that is released on Sundays. Right, so this was the beginning of the week, and prices had come down into this area. Now, if you were a buyer of the pound, what you would be looking to do is looking at the daily demand zone, going down into a lower time frame. I trade the 4-hour, and then looking for an entry. Now, I have a little indicator, right, my candlestick entries. And here would have been one of the entries that was provided. I'm not a buyer of the pound, and I'm not going to pretend that I took this trade at the moment with Brexit going on. But if you were, you know, taking this trade, right, from a risk reward perspective and from a technical perspective, this is what you'd be looking for, right? This is the kind of trade you'd be looking for, where you have an expensive area, the market high, right? So you have demand from a daily perspective, you have a high, right, which is an expensive area. You have a cheap area, which is demand. When prices come back down to this cheap area, what you want to look for is your upside potential, right? Is, do I have enough upside potential before the crowded exit, before traders start to look to take profit? So again, look at this, 2-to-1, right? You have enough upside potential before everyone else starts looking at this recent market high and starts to also look to take profit, whoever was around here. You have enough risk reward, which is what you really should be looking at, right? Is considering spatial awareness, yeah? Now, what we're gonna look at is compare that with, for example, the dollar yen. So on the dollar yen, we also have prices that have come down into a demand zone. This would have been supply zone, push up into what is known as a potentially expensive area, and we get a pullback. Now again, going down into a lower time frame chart and understanding where we may have, you know, an entry, right, we ended up getting a two candle entry right here, these two green candles there, stop below the market low. But now you can start to see where, as far as a risk reward perspective goes, we haven't got that much upside potential right now. Supply potentially is coming into the market from a technical analysis perspective. We don't know what's going on fundamentally, or well I do anyway, with the Japanese yen and the dollar. You know, I want to be a buyer of the dollar, but obviously there's risk off, risk on sentiment, etc., etc. But why wouldn't I have taken this? Because is it worth the risk? Is it worth my time risking my hard-earned money for just a one-to-one risk reward? That's a question that you have to, you know, answer for yourself. But for myself, no, it isn't, right? I would prefer prices to come further down, by if it does come further down, right, and then have a better risk reward to the upside. Yeah, so it's something to always think about. Spatial awareness, risk reward isn't just okay, I'm gonna enter, you know, here and this is where the entry is. Think about overall market structures. Think about who else is getting in, who else is gonna get out. Does that represent good risk reward? What are the likelihood of what is the likelihood of prices breaking through an expensive area? You have to take all these things into consideration, and it just adds a bit of higher level analysis when it comes to taking trades and being selective. My mentor Mark, a great trader, told me that there is something called level and what's a trade selection. You have to be selective. It's not every single setup you should take, right? If it fits your rules, and these are the things that do fit your rules or don't fit your rules, then fine. But you have to understand what is going to be a good risk reward for you and what isn't. Yeah, and selecting trades is something that you have to, you know, learn to do, and learn to refuse trades if they don't fit your plan. Just because you see an entry doesn't mean it's a great entry. So with that being said, if you do have any questions, definitely leave them in the comment section below if you're watching this on YouTube, or you can email me at info@trading180.com. I hope you all have a great trading week, and you've had a great trading week so far. And if you've locked in some profits, great. If you haven't, don't worry. It's only, again, 1 week in 52 in the next, you know, 104, etc., 2 years, 3 years, 4 years that you're going to be trading. So just as long as you manage your risk, go for more than you risk, give yourself the best chance possible, you know, to continually make profits. And remember, from a risk reward perspective, if you're going for 2-to-1s and you're winning at 40%, then you're making money. So guys, take care, and I'll speak to you soon.